Good morning to all. Myself Jakir Hussain, e-content developer. I welcome to all to my today's session. I am conducting the session for the course Switchgear and Protection. The topic for this session is types of lightning arresters and surge absorbers taken from unit number 1. The objective of this session is to learn construction and working principles of lightning arresters and surge absorbers. Before starting this session, we will have a recap what we have studied in the previous session. In the previous session, you have studied what do you mean by overvoltage or transient voltages, causes of overvoltages, lightning phenomena, and overvoltages due to lightning. Overvoltages or transient voltages means the sudden rise in voltage for a very short duration on the power system is known as surge voltage or transient voltages. These transient voltages or surge voltages on the power system may come from switching and from other causes, but the most important and dangerous surges are those caused by lightning. The lightning surges may cause serious damage to the equipments connected in the power system, such as generators, transformers, etc. These lightning surges may be of direct strokes on the equipment or the strokes on the transmission line that reaches the equipment as a traveling waves. It is therefore necessary for the system to protect from these two problems. The most commonly used devices for protection against lightning surges are earthing screen, overhead ground wires, lightning arresters, or surge absorbers. The earthing screens and overhead ground wires provide protection to the equipments, but it will not provide the protection to the equipment from the direct strokes, but it will not provide any protection for the traveling waves. To protect the equipments or the system from the traveling waves, we have to use the lightning arresters and surge absorbers. Then one by one we will take what are the lightning arresters and how they will work, and what are the surge absorbers and how they will work. Then the lightning arrester. What do you mean by a lightning arrester? A lightning arrester or a surge diverter is a protective device which conducts the high voltage surges on the power system to the ground. Types of lightning arresters. There are several types of lightning arresters. They are rod gap arrester, horn gap arresters, multi gap arresters, expulsion type lightning arresters. We will see the construction and how they will work when there is a surge voltage or a transient voltage in the system, and how it will protect the equipments connected in the system. To understand a lightning arresters, we will take a basic form of lightning arresters to understand how a lightning arrester will protect our equipment against the traveling waves. This structure consists of a spark gap. The gap is adjusted in such a way that for normal supply voltages, there is no breakdown of the gap when the high transient voltages or high voltages flows through the line, this the air between the gap is breaks down and a spark is struck between the gap. One more element that is connected in series with the spark gap is non-linear resistor. The characteristics of this non-linear resistor is to provide a very high resistance to the normal power frequency voltages and very low resistance to the transient voltages or the surge voltages. Under normal operating conditions, the voltage in the line or the current in the system is not sufficient to produce a spark between the gap. When a high voltage occurs in the system, a spark is produced in the gap and creating a short circuit in the system. But the resistor, the nonlinear resistor connected in the system, whose resistance goes down to the high voltages and it provides a path to the high current to divert it into the ground. This is how generally a lightning arrestor works. We will take and one by one all the arrestors to understand how they are constructed and how they will work in the system to protect our apparatus. The first one is rod gap arrestor. If you see the diagram, you will see there are two rods made up of iron and the length of each rod is 1.5 cm. They are bent in the form of a right angle. There is a gap between these two rods. The one end of the rod is connected to the line, the other one rod is grounded, properly grounded. Generally, the gap length is so adjusted that the breakdown should occur at 80% of spark over voltages. Under the normal operating condition, the gap remains inoperative. On the occurrence of the high voltage, the surge on the line, the gap sparks over and the surge current is conducted to the earth. The second one in the line is horn gap arrestor. This horn gap arrestor consists of two horn shaped metal rods A and B separated by a small gap. The horns are so constructed that the distance between them gradually increases as we move upwards. One end of the horn is connected to the line, the other end of the horn is connected to the apparatus to be protected through choke coil and resistance. The work of the resistance here is to limit the current, and the choke will not allow any quick changes in the system. That means it offers a very high opposition to the flow of transient voltages or surge voltages, and it will allow the normal frequency voltages to pass through it very easily. Under normal condition, the gap is non-conducting. On the occurrence of the over voltage, the spark over voltages voltage takes place across the gap. The heated air around the arc and the magnetic effect of the arc causes the arc to travel up the gap. The arc moves progressively into the position 1, 2, 3 as marked in the diagram. At some position of the arc, the distance may be too great for the voltage to maintain the arc, therefore the arc extinguishes from the gap. The third type of arrestor is multi-gap arrestor. As you can see in the diagram, it consists of a series of metallic cylinder insulated from one another and separated by a small intervals of gap. The first cylinder, that is A, is connected in the line into the line, the other to the ground through a series resistance. The series resistance limits the power arc by the inclusion of the series resistance. The degree of protection against traveling waves is reduced. In order to solve this problem, some of the gaps, for example B to C, are shunted by a resistor as shown in the figure. Under the normal conditions, the point B is at earth potential and the normal supply voltage is unable to break down the series gap. On the occurrence of an overvoltage, the breakdown of the series gap between A and B occurs and a spark occurs. The heavy current after breakdown will choose the straight path from B to C instead of the shunt resistor. When the surge is over, the arcs B to C goes out and any power current following the surge is limited by the two resistors, that is shunt resistor and series resistance in the system. These type of arrestors are used where the voltage level is less than 33 kV. The next type of arrestor is expulsion type arrestor. The expulsion type arrestor is made up of two parts. One is rod gap arrestor and second one is the fiber tube. The gap in the fiber tube is formed by two electrodes. The upper electrode is connected to the rod gap and the lower electrode is connected to the earth. On the occurrence of the over voltage on the line, the series gap A dash, as marked in the diagram, is spanned and an arc is struck between the electrodes, resulting in the arc is struck between the electrodes. The heat of the arc vaporizes some of the fiber in the fiber tube and producing a neutral gas. In a very short period of time, a high pressure is built up in the tube and this and is expelled through the lower electrode, which is hollow one. As the gas leaves the tube quickly, it carries away ionized air around the arc. This deionizing effect is so strong that the arc goes out at a current zero and will not be re-established in this system. The next type of arrestor is wall type arrestor. It consists of two assemblies, series spark gaps, non-linear resistor disc. The spark gap is a multiple assembly consisting of a number of identical spark gap in a series. Each gap consists of two electrodes with a fixed gap spacing. The voltage distribution across the gap is maintained constant by means of additional elements called the grading resistors across the gap. And the second part is a set of non-linear resistors. As we have studied, the non-linear resistor has a characteristics to provide a low resistance path. The resistance of the non-linear resistor decreases when over voltages or transient voltages comes into the system. When the normal frequency voltage returns back, its resistance improves. Its resistance increases. When normal condition remains, the normal the system voltage is insufficient to cause the breakdown of the air assembly. On the occurrence of an overvoltage, the breakdown of the series gap takes place and the surge current is diverted to the earth. In this way, these arrestors provide protection to the equipment connected in the system against the traveling waves in the electric power system. Now let us see how a surge absorber will work. A surge absorber is a protective device which reduces the stiffness of wavefront of a surge by absorbing the surge energy. The surge absorber and the lightning arresters or surge diverter does the same work. It removes the traveling waves or the surge voltages from the system, but the way in which they are different. The surge diverter diverts the surge to the earth. The surge absorber absorbs the surge energy and dissipates into the atmosphere as a heat energy. A simple form of surge absorber is shown in this diagram. It is connected between the line and the transformer or the equipment to be protected. Here, a capacitor is acting as a surge absorber. We know that the reactance of a capacitor, that is XC, is equal to 1 upon 2 pi FL. With the increase in the frequency, the reactance of the capacitor decreases. With the increase in the frequency, the reactance of the capacitor decreases. With the decrease in the frequency, the reactance of the capacitor increases. Surges or transients are of high frequency. Therefore, whenever the surges or transients comes into the system, the the frequency of the system increases, which in turn reduces the reactance of the condenser. Due to this, it offers a low resistance path to the surge voltages or transient voltages. It almost works as a short between the line and the ground. Therefore, these transient voltages or surge voltages is conducted to the ground. When the supply returns back to the normal power frequency voltages, the reactance of this capacitor becomes high and it will not allow or no current will flow through the capacitor to the ground. It will oppose the flow of current through it. Another type of surge absorber is a choke coil connected in parallel with the resistor, and this structure is connected in between the line and the transformer or the equipment to be protected. This combination will protect the system against traveling waves in the system and the system. As we know, inductive reactance, the formula is XL is equal to 2 pi FL. Here the frequency, if the frequency increases, the reactance also increases. If the frequency decreases, the reactance also decreases, as the reactance of the inductor is directly proportional to the frequency of the system. For the surge voltages, or when the surge or transient voltages occurs in the system, it associated with the high frequency. As a result, the inductive coil, the choke coil, offers a very high resistance to the flow of transient voltages or transient currents, and that's why they are forced to move through the resistance connected in parallel to the choke coil. When they pass through the resistance, it is converted into a heat energy and dissipated into the atmosphere. On the other hand, for the power frequency, the choke coil will allow, it will offers a least resistance and allow that voltages
to pass to the equipment without affecting the system. In this way, this circuit protects our system against traveling waves in the system. Another type of surge absorber is Ferranti surge absorber. Here in this type of absorber, you are having a coil, hollow air core coil, and surrounded by this one is a metallic case which is insulated with the main line, and it covers this metallic air core coil completely. This structure is similar to a transformer, where the inductor forms the primary of the transformer. The dissipator, that is that metal cover, we also call it as a dissipator. That dissipator forms the short circuited secondary. When the surges come into the system, then the system, the work of this one, when the surge voltages comes up into the system, is used up in the form of a heat generated in the dissipator due to transformer action. When the surge voltages flow into the air cooled coil, it is mutually linked to the dissipator, and it induces a current into the secondary of the transformer. That here is a dissipator, and that energy is converted into heat energy as it is acting as a short circuit secondary. Therefore, that energy is converted into a heat energy and dissipated into the atmosphere. These type of surge absorbers are used to protect the transformers in the system. Transformers are protected by using this system. These are the surge absorbers used in the system. Now let us try to assess what we have learned today. Let us take the MCQ to understand what we have learned in this session. The first question is, which of the following is not a protective device against lightning or voltages? The options are rod gaps, surge absorber, horn gaps, and isolator. Which of the following is not a protective device against the lightning or voltages? Rod gap is a protective device, surge absorbers also is a protective device, horn gap is also a protective device. Isolator is your answer. The isolator is just like a switch. It connect and disconnect the line. The second question is, a lightning arrestor provides dash between line and earth during operation. The options are low impedance path, high impedance path, low resistance path, high resistance path. The question is, the lightning arrestors provide dash between the line and earth during operation. The answer is low impedance path. When it provides the low impedance path, that's why the surge voltages or the high current is diverted from the line into the earth. Otherwise, it will remain in the line itself. Question number 3. Location of a lightning arrestor is near a generator, transformer, bus bar, circuit breakers. As we know, the lightning arrestors, for what purpose we are using? We are using to protect our apparatuses that is connected in the power system. Therefore, our answer is transformer. Fourth question. Lightning arrestors are used in the power system to protect electrical equipments against direct strokes of lightning, overvoltage due to indirect lightning strokes, power frequency overvoltages, overcurrent due to lightning. Lightning arresters are used in the power system to protect electrical equipment against. Our answer is power frequency over voltages. Lightning arresters are used to protect our equipment against over voltages. That's why our answer is power frequency over voltages. Next question, surge absorbers dash the energy of traveling waves. The options are absorbs, reflects, diverts, partly absorbs and partly diverts. One can easily try to answer this question by just observing the name of the device. It is a surge absorber. Therefore, our answer is absorbs. It absorbs the surge voltage and dissipate into the atmosphere. Sixth question. In rod gap lightning arrester, the gap length is adjusted such that the breakdown occurs at dash percentage of spark over voltages. The options are 60, 80, 90 and 70. Our answer is 80. This we have studied in the rod gap lightning arresters. Next question, the choke used in horn gap lightning arrester offers. The choke, you try to remember the formula XL is equal to 2 pi FL. The options are high reactance at power frequency and low reactance at transient frequency, low reactance at power frequency and low reactance transient frequency, high reactance at power frequency and high reactance at transient frequency, low reactance at power frequency and high reactance at transient frequency. Try to remember the formula XL is equal to 2 pi FL and the surge voltage is associated with the high frequency. Therefore, our answer is high reactance at power frequency and low reactance at the transient frequency. Eighth one, which of these statement is false with respect to expulsion type lightning arresters? Expulsion type lightning arresters. Which one is false? The options are, it can perform limited operations. B, it cannot be mounted in enclosed equipments. C, the voltage per ampere characteristics is poor. It is expensive. Try to remember that expulsion type lightning arresters. The answer is, it is expensive. It is made up of rod gap arrester and again one more tube. In that we are using the fiber content. It is having a fiber tube inside this one, and that fiber is converted into a gas. A small amount of fiber is converted in gas and dissipated into the atmosphere. Therefore, this type of arrester we can use only for few operation. We cannot use for more operation. That's why it becomes an expensive lightning arresters. Next one, Ferranti surge absorber contains core inductor. Which type of core inductor? The options are iron, air, steel and aluminium. The answer is air core inductor, because heat is produced. That's why you should have an air core inductor. Next one, a simple surge absorber is made by connecting dash with the equipment. Capacitor in parallel, choke in parallel, capacitor in series, resistance in series. Try to remember that diagram of capacitor or condenser surge absorber. Our answer is capacitor in series. These are the my references of this presentation. I hope with these this topic is completely clear to you. I hope it is going to help you. I take this opportunity to thank who have given me this opportunity. Thank you. Thank you, one and all.